It's a pleasure to welcome Bill Murphy back to the show. Gold Antitrust Committee, GATA, 20 years with Chris Powell exposing the gold market manipulation. Welcome back.
Thanks for having me, Chris.
You know, last week, a really good week for the precious metals. We saw silver pop 50 cents. XAU looked like he was trying to find a floor, and gold moved a little higher. And then, of course, we hear of a big dump. According to Zero Hedge, gold dropped a key support after $2 billion dropped on the market.
You've heard from me for years, except that they're getting more extreme and more desperate. The gold cartel did their thing again. For the past 4 years in a row, the day after Thanksgiving, they struck and knocked gold and silver down and buried it. This time, silver finally broke out, and they just killed it again. And I think it's leading to price explosions. But in the meantime, they just carry on. But here we are today, before we go into our Thanksgiving, and gold's not far from making a new recent high, and it's coming right back. And this is really important. This is very different. In the past month or so, every time the gold cartel is attacked, the gold and silver prices have come right back. They're not getting any traction on the downside. And I think that that just shows how the pressure is building in each of these markets to explode.
I do see different price action in the markets. It's much more bullish now. Signs of accumulation after about a boring year or two, sideways moves. People lose all interest. They start taking a look at the S&P and Bitcoin, and they forget about the precious metals and what a great improvement they can add to your portfolio. And Jim Rickards agrees with you. He just wrote this week that the gold trend reversal is now moving higher, and he's seeing a flight to quality where people have just lost confidence in central banks all around the world, not just here domestically, but in Europe and in Asia. He says forget about higher interest rates. He's not worried about it. Gold and silver are going to move higher regardless.
So, obviously, I agree with Jim, and all I can see, it's classic in the sense that in the U.S. anyway, people are capitulating like I haven't seen in 20 years. They're quitting. They're going into bitcoins, they're getting out cash, they're doing anything but staying in gold and silver after a six-year, seven-year bear market. And it's a classic sign of a bottom, and it's a further indication that we're headed much, much higher.
Exactly, because it's usually as the weak hands sort of give up, toss in the towel, that we see the bottom come into place. And, you know, the more forward-looking folks, they are saying, hey, you know, these are discounts. This is just what I need for my portfolio. Well, as we move forward, obviously we're going to have a new Fed head here in 2018. My guess is it's, you know, meet the new boss, same as the old boss. No big changes expected.
No, I don't think it really matters. I mean, there's power behind the scenes that really makes things happen. And I don't... The real key, and I always say this because I believe it to be true, it's what the gold cartel can get away with. They're petrified of losing control of gold and silver because if they really explode, it'll expose what they've been doing regarding money and all sorts of other issues. So they're trying to keep it under control. And I think at some point, the physical markets are just going to explode. We're hearing about tightness in New York now in gold and in London. And it's going to have its effect. And all of a sudden, out of nowhere, it just explodes. In the meantime, we're going through the same drills.
But again, I do think it's a little different this time. The price action is much more bullish. Every time there's a pullback, we're starting to see the buyers come out ahead.
Physical markets behind the scenes, much firmer than being led to believe. And I think this is what you're seeing, and you're correct. And I think it's leading to something major pretty soon.
Take a look at the S&P 500. Sure, we could keep drifting higher, but for the most part, it seems as though the risk-to-reward ratio gets less and less appealing, whereas where would you turn? Well, I mean, Bitcoin obviously could move higher as well, but that's had a parabolic move, so you got to be careful. What's left? You know, I mean, well, the precious metals. Of course, the problem is we've been saying that for so long that I'm sure people discount, you know, the veracity of our comments here today, but let's hope not. Bill, give folks your prediction forecast for 2018 on precious metals.
You could have said this a year or two ago, I suppose, but gold and silver right now are by far the cheapest assets, financial assets on the planet. They are going to explode. And I'll go back to what I've been saying now for a while. If they're desperate to keep silver below 21, if it gets above that number, it'll trade it in a similar fashion to Bitcoin, maybe not as dramatic, but you're going to see some credible moves. And I just hope it comes sooner rather than later.
Let me leave this with the listeners today. An article from GATA.org, by the way, that gold has outperformed the S&P 500 since the year 2001. This is from Sprott, a big friend of the show here, and I know a friend of yours as well. Sprott analysts just pointing out, despite the amazing moves in the S&P, and of course the sluggishness we've had to endure for a year or two following the bottom in, I guess, 2015, 16, depending on what you want to call it. Doesn't matter. If you look at the bigger picture, the overriding gains are with gold. It's just outperformed shares domestically. This, I think, has puzzled a lot of sharp analysts, and it continues, and I think that that discrepancy probably offers a value opportunity for our listeners today.
Couldn't agree more, except this time where the moves, if I'm correct, maybe I'm not, I don't know, but it's going to be explosive this time like we've never seen before. You're not going to have a gradual move up anymore.
And, you know, we could have that Bitcoin-like moment. Here's the interesting parallel. There's only so much of the stuff. You can print dollars, you can print fiat money, and you can print equity, shares, and bonds all day long. Good luck printing gold. Bill Murphy, any contact information?
Well, people can sign up for a two-week free trial at www.lemaitrepolecafe.com or go to Gata.org and get on my colleague Chris Powell's list. And we're out there fighting a good fight, and we're going to win. It's just taking a lot longer than we had hoped for.
Isn't that the truth? But, hey, you know what? Good things sometimes worth waiting for.
Bill Murphy, thank you.
Thanks for having me, Chris.
With stocks hitting new highs, the next sector to fly could be the precious metals. GoldSeek's top industry analyst just uncovered another solid gold opportunity, Silvercorp Metals. Silvercorp's key property is located in China, the largest gold producer in the world. Silvercorp's net income is soaring, up 589%. Production eclipsed guidance by 27.5%, totaling 6.5 million ounces. Mining operations are literally printing silver at only $3.82 per ounce. AISC net byproducts credits for the fiscal year 2017. Sales increased 51% year over year, and cash flow from operations more than doubled to $80 million. Silvercorp continues to set the industry standard with reduced costs, equity appreciation, a solid dividend, and improved free cash flow. Silvercorp is uniquely positioned to capitalize on rising silver, lead, and zinc prices. To learn more about the exceptional opportunity in Silvercorp Inc., direct your web browser to silvercorpmetals.com, ticker symbol SVM in the U.S. and Canada. Remember to treat your portfolio with a core position in Silvercorp Metals.
GoldSeek employees may or may not own shares. Nothing contained herein should be construed as investment advice.